Hello everyone, welcome to the new tutorial by aipython. So here we are going to understand how we can install Python on our system. Here in this tutorial I'll be basically focusing on installing Python on Windows platform, that is mostly 64-bit architecture. So it's a very easy process to install Python. To get Python binaries from internet, you can go to python.org. So once you go there, this page will open. Here you can go to the download section, and in the download section you can go to Windows, because we are installing on Windows. There are a lot of released Python version from python.org for Windows, and the latest one is 3.7.3, but we are not installing or downloading Python 3.7.3. rather than we'll be going for Python 3.6.7. Why 3.6.7? Okay, the most of the libraries from machine learning or deep learning or artificial intelligence are run without any issue on 3.6.7 as of now. So for example, if you're working on deep learning with TensorFlow, then there could be some files which says it should have Python 3.6.7. maybe definitely in the future they will definitely incorporate with all latest version, but to be on the safer side, there are literally very less difference between all these versions, especially for Python 3. I'm not talking about Python 2 right now, so we'll jump directly into installing this Python 3.6.7. so we have a lot of options here available. What we'll do, we'll go to 86 and 64 executable installer. So this will install a small package, very little size package on your system, and then from there you can start installing. So we'll download it from here quickly. So it is downloaded, it's kind of a download manager for Python. So we'll click it here, it will open up a window to install Python. So here there are other options like install and customize. Install now will install Python the default path, so we do not want to use it. We want to customize the installation, so we'll go to customize installation, okay. So these are the optional features, but I would recommend for a beginner that you should not be confused with this one. So let it be as it is, in default architecture, default settings, so that you don't have to struggle around after installing the system. So we'll go to next, and there option to install for all users and associate file with Python, create such shortcut for installed application, add Python to environment variable. This is very important. Until unless you don't add this to Python to environment variable, what will happen, it basically doesn't recognize, window doesn't recognize Python as installed. It doesn't know the path where it can launch Python. If you write in command prompt Python, so after adding it to the Python environment variable, it can work very easily. So we'll browse the location, and we'll give it to C drive. We'll go to C drive, and then here we can create a folder. So Python, I'm installing 3.6.7. so this is the shortcut I'm following. If you want, you can also follow, otherwise you can write 3.6.7. so this is a very easy and convenient way to write Python 3.6.7. so we'll go to Python 3.6.7. I don't know why it's not selecting. So Python 3.6.7, okay. So the default directory is set. Now we can go ahead with installation. So it will install. It will take a little bit of time. So the Python is installed successfully in our system. There are few requirement like disable path length limit. So what it does, basically there is a path limit from Windows that you cannot enter a path which has 260 and more character. For example, you go into C drive, my program file, Windows, maybe it go deeper into the folder architecture and then select a path. The path become very long. So in this case, we would like to disable the path limit, and we can continue ahead with the path, disable the path limit. So setup is successful. Congratulations.